what is the nature of UPSC Civil Services preliminary examination. Now, in this part, we are focusing only on prelim examination. Prelim examination is divided into two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Paper 1 is actually we are considering for counting of mark, for cutoff mark, paper 1 is important. Paper 2 is considered as qualifying level. That means you have to score 66 marks out of 200, then you are qualified. Your marks are not considered into score. So your cutoff will be of out of 200, because paper 1 is of 200 mark, paper 2 is also of 200 mark, but your cutoff will not consider over there. It's clear. Now we are going to discuss about paper 1 first. Paper 1 is comprising of all possible knowledge in this world. That's why we are calling it as general study. General world. I'm really afraid of general world. So you are aware when Muhammad Ghaznavi, those who are history students, they are aware that when Muhammad Ghaznavi went to Somnath, he ordered general slaughter over there. When person is going into operation theater, the question is that where local anesthesia is given or general anesthesia is given. So like that general study, I am afraid in, because it is comprising of all possible things under the roof. Whatever knowledge we have, usually we are considering 10 plus 2 level knowledge. It is not that hard also, but not that easy also. I don't want to afraid you, but I don't want to motivate you in this way that it's very easy, everybody can come. No. So if you are having hard working ability, then only you can try this examination, because you have to study a lot. Let me clarify. You have to study physics, chemistry, biology. Three subjects are there from science side. I'm particularly saying that physics, chemistry and biology, that is from science side. Geography is there. We can consider it from art side. Along with geography and combination of physics, chemistry and biology, another subject is there, that is called as environmental science. So it is also there. So I am revising physics, chemistry, biology, geography, environmental science. Then subject from arts side, but named as science, that is political science, or rather we are calling here this as Indian polity. Then economics, history. Now we are splitting out history as Indian history and Indian freedom struggle, that is national freedom struggle. So two subjects we have to consider as history part only. And we may ask question that you studied history, you studied geography, national freedom struggle, but what is use of all that if present knowledge is not there? And then obviously I have to think of the most important subject right now here, that is current affairs. So all these subjects are there under this roof. I am revising physics, chemistry, biology, environmental science, geography, then history, national freedom struggle, Indian polity, economics and current affairs. All these subjects you have to study in paper 1. No doubt paper 1 is objective. Now the thing is that focus on examination. It is not necessary. Say in academics you are very clear that this subject you have to study for these many marks. Or rather in subject we are aware that this is the chapter. Where, for example, X chapter is there for 5 marks, Y chapter is there for 3 marks. So like that, wattage is there. But in case of this civil services examination, prelim examination, they are not providing anything like that. They may ask more questions on environmental science. May be possible, they may not ask even a single question on nuclear physics. So like that, any question they can ask here. In this thing, so there is no particular wattage for particular subject. So you should not consider that okay, this year may be possible I am not studying out science, all PCB, physics, chemistry, biology I am considering as option, and I will go for other subject. Maybe possible in that year paper will be focused in science area. You may say that okay, environmental science I am keeping aside, but maybe possible maximum focus will be there on environmental science or current affair, and like that you are not very clear here about this. Paper 2. Now we are switching over to paper 2. Paper 2 is considering all good things. See, my favorite paper, if you ask, that is of paper 2. It's very nice paper. And an officer must have knowledge of paper 2, what I feel personally, not UPSC feel. And so, it is of comprehension skill. That means, what is your grasping power? What is your eligibility to grasp from given content and able to answer? So paper 2, that is having comprehension skill, then logical reasoning, analytical reasoning, data interpretation. Now data interpretation is most critical thing. Many people and officers also are not able to read out even a graph. Many times this happened, and therefore it is actually necessary thing that at officer level this minimum eligibility you must have. So that is data interpretation. Then simple arithmetics. And what is the most important that officer should have, that is decision making and problem solving skill along with communication skills. So all these things are there in paper 2. Obviously communication skill means verbal and non-verbal communication and all that is included, that is there in paper 2. In 2011, this paper 2 was important paper that was introduced. But by few years, students started opposing this paper, and ultimately this is democracy, so paper 2 made qualifying. But because of that, what exactly happened, I want to tell that qualifying marks from paper 2 to obtain that qualifying marks is not that difficult task. For a normal person, if you ask to run 100 meter in 10 minutes, then it's quite easy. Run, instead of that, I should say walk 100 meters in 10 minutes. So it's that easy. But if I am saying that, okay, within 15 seconds, I'm not talking of 11 and 10 seconds, within 15 seconds you have to cross 100 meter, then it is difficult. So like that, when paper 2 was considered under scoring subject, then it was difficult because you have to solve 80 questions in 120 minutes, that is 2 hours, and that was difficult. But now you have sufficient time. Actually you have option and option and option. You can check out nearly 50% paper is focused on comprehension. If you are eliminating that, then also with decision making, problem solving, logical reasoning, analytical reasoning, arithmetics, data interpretation and all that, you can score 66 marks is quite easy. Each question carries 2.5 marks. Obviously, negative marking is there. Yes. That is called as 0.33. Or simply, if your 3 questions answers are wrong, then they are deducting out marks of 1 question straight. That means you are going to lose all 3 questions mark, plus as a penalty, they will charge you penalty, and 1 question mark that will be deducted from your score. That means suppose you have scored 20 marks and now you lost 3 questions. Each question is carrying out 2.5 mark. Then you lost all that 3 questions mark, plus your score was initially 20, from that they will deduct 2.5 marks because single question carries 2.5 mark in paper 2. In paper 1, 100 questions are there, that means each question carries 2 marks. So if it is in paper 1, then they will deduct 2 marks for your 3 mistakes. So that is the criteria of prelim, and therefore now it's very clear for you that you have to focus more on paper 1, but you should not ignore paper 2, because if you are not able to score 66 marks in paper 2, then whatever your score of paper 1, they are not going to consider, and therefore you have to focus more on paper 1, but we should not ignore paper 2, otherwise we are not able to reach till the target. Alright, so this is about prelim examination we discussed.